The Haftarah this week from Parshat Vayeshev is from the Book of Amos. His prophecy shouts out from us from a faraway time and place. Amos was, in his own words, a peasant from the poor village of Tekoa on the edge of the Judean desert. He appeared at the sanctuary of Beit El in the northern kingdom of Israel at the peak of its power in the mid-8th century BCE. Amos' speech begins benignly enough. All the powerful, wealthy nations that Israel had subdued were actually paying for their sins, being punished. But then he issues his shocking warning that the Judean and Israelite chosenness by God, nor wealth, nor power, nor ritual sacrifices would protect them if they continued to pervert justice, oppress the widow, the poor, and the stranger. Unless they changed, the fate of Judah and the kingdom of Israel would be no different than all the others. Amos issues the warning using a metaphor that translates nicely into American English as, "You have three strikes on you, four strikes, and you're out." Amatziah, the high priest of Beit El, responds to him dismissively. "Go back to your little village in Judah and make your living prophesying there. Leave our royal city alone." Amos has come back to Amatziah that he's neither a prophet nor a son of a prophet, but a day worker, a dresser of sycamore trees, condemned prophets as a type of sophist employed to satisfy the elites with nice messages. Amos, on the other hand, was the real thing. So how do we identify the real biblical prophecy and the real prophet? A central point in Abraham Joshua Heschel's book, The Prophets, is that Western philosophy, beginning with the Greeks, based ethics on distancing the mind from pathos, the emotional response to pain. The philosopher Immanuel Kant grounded modern ethics on the use of reason to separate our subjective circumstance from the truth of a situation and discern a categorical imperative that would guide ethical decision-making. The ability of the individual to make autonomous ethical decisions using reason is the philosophical basis for citizenship in a modern liberal democracy. The Shoah revealed the limitations of modern ethics. When the most educated and cultured nation in the world, its intellects and its scientists fell under the Nazi spell. This blow to ethical philosophy was despairing, opening a door to postmodernism that abandoned ethical reason to the point that nowadays our children are taught in college that the truth, that there are no truths at all, only narratives. Heschel wanted to preserve the primacy of autonomous ethics, and in so doing, to save liberalism, using the religious language of prophecy. Central to Heschel is the idea that God cares about human beings. He called prophecy eternity, entering the moment. It's a message that appeared out of nowhere to interrupt the natural course of events, issuing divine demands and warning in the hope of saving a society from itself. It exposed the stark and painful truths about social rot, challenging conventional wisdom and threatening elites. And despite the many failures of prophecy, God continues to hope that someday human society might even reach those demands and achieve its potential. The ethical and moral messages of prophecy remain as radical, dangerous, and true in our technologically advanced society as they were three millennia ago. Prophecy was the equivalent of a viral social media message, capturing the popular imagination with poignant speech. Yet the difference is that viral messages today protect the tweeters and promulgators of fake news, while the prophets were out there in the public square, together with their prophecy, risking themselves, usually against overwhelming odds, and very often against their own will. Follow the biblical prophets from Moshe to Amos to Yeshayahu and Yirmiyahu. A common denominator is that their prophecy assumes complete control over them and their fate. At the end of the Haftarah, Amos sums up this profound experience with a brief rhetorical question. A lion roars, who doesn't fear? God speaks, who doesn't prophesy? Shavua Tov from Schechter.